Let me ask you about this IPCC report. It certainly grabbed the headlines in every major press report yesterday. What was your take on the warnings that were issued from this report?
Thank you very much for having me. The report is really a big warning signal to the world leaders and decision makers. It is the first major report around the climate science since 2013 by the IPCC, and it really is a fundamental update of the science of our understanding of the climate system, with a number of big improvements, actually.
If you consider where we are politically, we have global coordination on key issues now, and there is certainly a push to try and hit certain climate goals. But what is the point of the coordination if we're not actually making enough progress to avoid disastrous outcomes from climate change? What can happen from here? How do you think the likes of President Biden and Macron can step up the agenda that we're seeing on climate change?
There's been a rather big strengthening of the climate policy process over the last year, with the presidency of Biden, Macron, and others have really stepped up quite a lot since coming into power compared to previous years. So I'm optimistic that we will have quite good progress in the next COP meeting in Glasgow. And this report, which really shows that we're really experiencing climate change events already today, I think it has really hit home, not only amongst politicians, but also with the public, where we are experiencing these extreme weather events, heat waves, floodings, drought. And this report makes it unequivocal that these events are connected to climate change and human influence on climate, and they are coming more frequently, and they are becoming more extreme. And I think this will, in the end, trigger more action on the international political scene.
Måns, given the urgency of the IPCC statement, do you think we actually just need to reprioritize the focus on technologies that we're looking at this stage? We do have technologies that would allow us to scrub greenhouse gases from the atmosphere, and yet they do look expensive at this stage, but surely it's worth paying a premium to get these technologies up and running in a meaningful way if the level of urgency is as high as the IPCC suggests. What do you think?
Yes, I agree. I think at this stage, and with what this report is showing, we cannot afford to take any options off the table. And I think we need to engage with these carbon removal technologies. We need to also engage very strongly with all the energy sources that can bring us to net zero, which is our only chance to avoid very dangerous climate change in the future. Even the most optimistic scenario of this report shows that we are going to be, and even if we are removing the fossil emissions, we're going to experience warming over the coming 20 years at a dangerous but hopefully manageable level. But even a little bit of continuation of fossil energy systems will lead us into dangerous territories.
Hi, I'm Giovanna Bersecci, and thank you for watching. You can check out more of our videos by clicking on the boxes on the screen. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more from CNBC International. Thank you for watching.